All right, welcome back. We are now in the second part of module 4. Remember in the previous part, I imported data from SQL Server, bringing in 4 tables, making sure that they have a relationship between them. Some of the relationships were identified automatically, detected by the tool. One of them I needed to do manually. And in this part, I will add some aspects to this model, bringing some additional data, combining it with the existing data, and making it more more complete model. So let me just first jump into the window, the manage window. And one of the things that in almost every model we do, we need, is a calendar table. Calendar tables are required if we want to do, because we have a date in the sales table, we do have a date column. But this is just a date. What if I want to filter on year, month, week, or so on? And also, what if I want to do some more sophisticated calculations that I will actually show you in a later module, like year-over-year comparisons and stuff? For all these purposes, we do need a calendar table. Now, in Excel 2016, we actually added a very easy way to do this. With previous versions, you will need to either create the table in Excel and bring data in Excel. By the way, I didn't mention, but you can actually create tables in Excel and bring them into the model. So one of the sources available to you is just the table in Excel. But here, you see that I go to the design tab in the window of the manage window, and I see that there is a data table here, and I can say, create me a new data table. So this is just one click, and it added a table to my model called calendar. It has one column of type date and additional columns, calculated columns, that add all kind of properties to it. The only thing I still need to do is to create a relationship between this new table and the rest of the tables. Oh, actually, because I had to redo it, I didn't do the, so let me very quickly do the relationship between locations and, locations here. So, because this is, we need it for the rest of it. So, and the table, the new table, which is just hiding here because of this the scale, let me bring it back. And now I can just create a relationship between the date here and the date in sales. It created everything I needed, only it didn't create now the relationship. It actually created the necessary data in the data in the calendar table for all the dates it found in any one of the tables. It analyzed all the tables found. In this case, there's only one date column, and it goes from 2011 to 2015. And this is why now I have data in the calendar table for all these years. If I want to, I can go to the data table and actually I can extend it. Once I'm on it, I can extend the dates and make dates for further years. But let's go, because we have work to do. Let's go back to Excel, and I want to create another query. This query is actually, the reason that I need to do another query is that this company has the data for sales data for the US in this SQL Server database, but sales data from other countries are sent as text files to this guy who's doing this analysis. And what I am this guy in this case, and I need to combine the data from the text files to the data from the SQL Server to be able to create some global analysis. So how do I do that? I go to another query from file from, and here it's not a single CSV, but actually it's a folder full of CSV data. Here is this folder. You see that there are a bunch of, in this case, 4 files. I copy the path, I paste it here, and now I will create a query from the entire content of this query. I have all kind of columns of properties of the file, which I'm not, at this point, I'm not interested in. I'm just interested in the first column, which is the content. I can click on this icon here and get myself into the editor with all the data in all these files combined together as one, as if they were one. The headers from the first file were used to become the headers for the entire file, which is fine for me. But there's a few cleanup things that I need to do. First of all, I need to create the calculated, what is called custom column here in the query. Remember, from country and zip, I need to do it also here. Because this will be actually the extension of the sales table, which already have this column. So merge column in the same way we did before. And it's going to be, again, the location. Here, it's very important to give it the same name, because this is how, when we append this data to the previous data, each column here would find its matching in the existing data. That's fine. Now, there's another little problem here, which is that each one of the files, and remember, there were four of them, has, as its first row, a header, the headers. And I need to get rid of all the other headers, except the one that was used for giving the headers for the entire file. Now, I cannot filter it from here, like I can actually go from here. So, for example, I can say in the zip file, I can, it's a text field, and I can say, I want to filter out all the rows which does not equal the word zip. But I would like to do it before, no, actually now it's I didn't filter the date yet, so it's actually a good time. I can say it does not equal, so the zip column does not equal the value zip itself, assuming there is no zip code called zip. And I'm filtering it out all, so by filtering the value of zip, I actually filtered the rows which were included the headers for the other files. Now that I got rid of those, I can actually go to the date field and apply the filter on the date field to include only years after 2011. Remember, I did the same for the sales, and there's no point in bringing me the international data from 1999 while I'm actually interested in 2011. All right, so now I have these four files, and I'm going to the close and load to dialog, because I actually don't want this query to be loaded to the data model as yet. I just want to define it, create it, and it will be ready for the next step. So I'm going to load it, but not really loaded. It's just a connection. It's not loaded to the data model, and also not loaded into Excel. So here it is, query one. It says connection only. Now I go back to the sales table and go again into the editor. And I'm going to add another step to this. So now this is the table. By the way, I want to draw your attention to these two columns, location and products, here. Those are very special columns that were added by the query, because it detected the relationship between this table and others. There's actually an option that I will not use here to select columns for these other tables and add them automatically to here. So you can just ignore them, and they will go. They will not do anything in the model if you don't use them. So I will use another step, which is called the append query. I will append another query to this query. So the query to append will be the one called query one. I just left it as a default name. I didn't bother to change its name to something else, because I knew that this will not become a table in the database, in the model eventually. So I didn't care much about giving it a meaningful name. And I click OK. So now I have another step. I want to also draw your attention to another element. And this is the fact that here I have some expressions that this is actually the actual script line that is doing, in this case, the append query. Each step here will have its corresponding line in the script. And this script is, we don't really are going to look at this at this point. We're not interested in the actual syntax. In more advanced use of the queries, you can actually start getting more to know this, the language this script is written on. It's, the language is called the M language. But for now, in our course here, we're not going to touch it for any for anything. So, but it's there. And actually, if you know what you're doing, you can go and actually apply some tweaks to the syntax. But for now, we are happy with that. And we are going to close and load. And Now, what will happen is that the sales query will fire again, repeat everything, all the steps, which starts by reading this 2 million rows from SQL Server. Once it's done reading the 2 million rows from SQL Server, it will start reading the rows from the query one, which is in itself four CSV files combined together. And the end result of the sales table is going to be the entire content of the sales table, starting filtering to only 2011, plus the text files appended to it, and all of them will become one big happy file, happy table in the model. And then subsequently, if I get this text files every month, I can just repeat this entire process and it will give me the entire global analysis. But what happened here? We get some yellow notification here and the model looks very funny. It shows me the same value for every sale. What happened? Actually, because now the sales table is not directly a table from the database, the tool recognized that they previously identified, detected the relationship between this sales table and the other tables are not valid anymore. So it decided to delete it. This is a functionality that we probably are going to change in the future, but it's actually very easy to fix because we have another new for 2016 functionality to detect the relationships from the data. So now when I clicked on it, it actually brought back the numbers to where they was, and we now have the data from all countries. And if I go to the location and pick the country and make it into a slicer, I see all the countries from which I have data, and I can see the data from France, and I can control click and see the data from France and Germany and so on. So now we have a truly global analysis of the data for this company. So to conclude, we added a calendar table using a functionality that was added to PowerPivot or to Excel, or to PowerPivot in Excel in this version of 2016. We also created another query from a folder of text files, added all the contents of this text files to the sales table, and eventually we got a model that has data both from SQL and from the text files, and it's now a global file. Thank you and see you in the next module.